So here are a few exercises that are really helpful for strengthening and getting more movement and mobility in your fingers, hands, wrists and forearms. And these movements are going to be weight bearing, so they're perhaps not the first place to start if you're feeling like your wrists and hands don't feel very strong and mobile, but these are the ones that you would build up to a little bit more. Okay, so we're going to start hands spreading on the mat, and feel like you're putting your fingers to the centre of the palm. So the fingers are pressing down fairly firmly, and then we're just going to circle the body around the hands and see how that feels. So you're pulling the weight away from the hands and then back over them. So it's not constant, and that's a nice way to just get the hands and wrists used to feeling the load of your body weight. You're just noticing how that feels through all the different places, left, right, forwards and back. And then a similar movement but back and forth. So feeling the weight shift forward into the fingers, the wrists, and then away again. And you can choose how far back to go, how far forward to go, depending on what you want to feel. And just noticing how much your wrists are happy to feel the weight go over them. And noticing as you come forward and the shoulders go over the wrists, you create about a 90 degree angle. And that's a passively loaded position. You're using your body weight to create that. So the next thing we're going to try is pulling back, lifting the wrists up and seeing what kind of angle is happening at the wrist. And you're trying to keep your elbows straight, pull your hands towards you as much as you can. So this is an active range where you're having to use your muscles and your own kind of effort to create that wrist extension. So as you can see, mine won't go quite to where it does when I reach forward and press my weight over the wrists. So doing that a few times, holding it for a couple of breaths, and as I do that, I'm feeling a really strong muscle contraction along my forearm. So it's training those muscles to work. I'm also really feeling my fingers as I try and pull them towards me. So doing that, I don't know, maybe 3 to 5 times, see how it feels. Does it feel like a useful way to work those wrists and hands? And there's other ways of doing this. This is just one way of finding the active range of wrist extension. Okay, and then coming back, giving your hands a little break, circling. And then hands back down. And we're just going to go side to side. And then start to peel your hands off the mat. So from the wrist all the way up to the fingers. And each time you peel, turning the hands around a little. And see how far your hands feel happy to turn. It might be fingertips pointing to the knees. It might not be quite that far around. So without forcing, just turning as much as feels possible for today. You can take the hands then closer to the knees and start to lean forwards and back. And I'm trying to hinge at the first knuckle, which is a real challenge for me, letting the elbows bend in a little. And now I'm just feeling a stretch all along that inner forearm and through the hands and the fingers. And I can really notice which fingers are happy to stay down and bend, which I have to try and press down a bit more. So without overdoing, just getting used to that feeling of stretching through the forearms, bending through the hands, and then going all the way back to the front. And again, coming up, circling your wrists. Okay, a nice counterpart to that one is to reach your arms out to the side and make strong fists. So you're squeezing your fingers together, and then pull the knuckles down towards the mat. And this then gives you a stretch all along the top of the forearm, so feeling that. Taking the knuckles forward, so that shifts the stretch a little bit, reaching them up towards the ceiling. And the whole time, now I'm trying to pull my fingers in towards me, down to the floor, and then turning the hands behind you. And doing that a few times, feeling this stretch right through the forearms, all the way to the wrists. So just see how many times that feels like a useful movement. And then keeping those fists squeezed in as much as you can, take the whole backs of your hands to the mat. And then you'll notice the elbows, it's much more comfortable with your elbows bent. And just see how much you can straighten the elbows, maybe going back and forth. And you might be able to get your arms completely straight. That's still quite a challenge for me. And again, it's that outer arm all the way down to the wrist and the hand, really feeling a stretch. And some of these movements can feel quite uncomfortable if you're not used to doing them. Most of us don't really target these specific areas that much. So just go gently. But you find if you practice them regularly, it becomes so much more manageable. Your body gets used to it and those muscle fibers start to adjust to that. This is one that's got easier for me, much easier than the lifting the hands we did earlier. Okay, and then from there, open your palms up onto the mat. Suddenly it'll be easier to straighten your elbows and see if you can get the thumbs pressing down into the mat as well. And then from there, remake your fists. So you're squeezing them in as much as you can. And this is the bit that has actually, I can see an improvement. It's getting easier. And then opening the hands back up. It's still a big old stretch on the backs of my hands and wrists. And now suddenly I can keep the elbows a little bit straighter. So maybe opening the hands and closing them again about 5 times, really slowly. And then coming back up, giving your hands another circle. Okay, so I can really feel I've moved all the tissues of the forearms, the wrists, and the hands now. So let's put that together as a little sequence, and that can then be a nice warm-up before you, say, play an instrument or you're going climbing, something like that. Okay, so we started with circling the weight over the wrist, pressing all the fingers down and slightly pulling them into the center of the palm. And then moving forwards and backwards. Again, so the weight is not constantly over the wrists and hands, you feel the shift towards and away. So each time the weight goes over, you can kind of re-feel how that is for your hands and let them warm up and get used to it. And then we did the wrist extension, pulling the hands towards you. Active wrist extension, straightening the elbows. Pull, pull, pull as much as you can. And then back to the passive range. Wrist extension, pulling up. Feeling the forearms contracting, the hands, the fingers. And back up. You can use your breath to help you as you inhale and exhale, just kind of staying with the sensations in the arms and the hands. And then coming back up, swaying side to side, starting to peel your hands off the mat. So we're trying to feel like the hands are pliable rather than kind of not something we can bend in the center of. And then maybe taking the hands closer to the knees, and going forwards and back, trying to create this hinge in the knuckles at the top of the palm, keeping the fingers down. You can even lean back, pick the thumbs up, take them across, see if you can touch the root of the baby finger, and back again. You can bend the elbows in, and then slowly make your hands back to center, and give them a little bit of a circle through the wrists. And just notice all the sensations, feeling how you've moved lots of things. And then reaching the arms out, pulling the knuckles down to the floor and circling. So this is feeling the stretch along the top of the arm, along top of the forearm, into the top of the wrist. And then hands down. Try a few sort of gentle bend and straightenings of the elbows. Opening the hands up on the mat, thumbs down, straightening the elbows, remaking your fists, squeezing in and opening up again. And then giving your hands another shake out, maybe circling them. Opening and closing. Taking a breath, just feeling all the sensations along the lower half of your arm.